He is immortal. Born in the Highlands of Scotland 400 years ago, he is not alone. There are others like him. Some good, some evil. For centuries, he has battled the forces of darkness, with holy ground his only refuge. He cannot die unless you take his head and with it his power. In the end, there can be only one. He is Duncan MacLeod, the Highlander.
Donna?
Yo, Rich. What's up, man?
Yeah. I'll catch you later, Jamal.
Yo, man, we playing ball. Dang, Donna with the women.
Hi, Richie. How are you doing?
Good. I hardly recognized you. You look great.
Yeah, I cleaned up my act a little. Took 6 months to get the purple out. It's been a while.
Yeah, 2 years. 1 minute you were there, and the next... Where'd you disappear to?
I stayed with my aunt in Philly.
Well, it's good to see you.
Yeah.
You gonna stick around this time?
Yeah. There's someone I want you to meet.
New boyfriend. No more Joey?
No, he's gone. But this guy's a real hunk. I think you'll like him.
I can't wait.
Come on, Jeremy. I want you to meet Richie. Richie? Say hello to Jeremy.
He's yours.
I'm pretty sure.
You had a baby?
It's kind of hard not to notice these things.
Well, yeah, I just... You know what I meant. Come here, little guy. So, you and Joey had a kid.
Joey's not the father, Richie.
Oh, yeah? Who's the lucky guy?
You are.
I gotta talk to you.
Let me know when you found the formula.
Formula?
We're getting in shape without training.
No, I'm sorry, Mac. I know I'm late, but something came up. Someone of us. Donna. You remember Donna?
No.
Well, anyway, she's back in town.
That's nice.
She brought someone with her.
Grab a rope.
Mac, she brought my son.
Your what?
Richie, man. Is anything you right? You saying you got a kid?
Yeah, a son, actually.
Hey, well, congratulations. That is good news, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it's fantastic.
No, man, that's great.
Isn't that great, MacLeod?
It's unbelievable.
Yeah, well, look, when you're passing out the cigars, you save one for me, all right?
You got it, Charlie.
A son.
Right. Thanks, man. Mac? Aren't you gonna say something?
Donna's made a mistake. Whoever the father is, it's not you. Here. Immortals can't have children.
Exactly, Mac. This happened before I became an immortal.
That's not the way it works.
Maybe I'm the first.
I wish it could happen, but it's not in the cards. We don't get to live happily ever after. Children aren't part of our lives. Can happen.
It just did. I'll see you later. Donna. How come you didn't tell me?
I was confused and afraid.
Of Joey?
Of you. I was afraid you wouldn't want us. Maybe you wouldn't believe me.
Donna, we're gonna work something out. It'll be okay. For all of us.
You mean that?
I promise.
And you'll come back!
I'd like a beer, please.
Take off! We're closed!
Too bad. I'm real thirsty.
Time to get out of here.
I said, please.
You crazy bastard!
Get up!
Louisville Slugger. Can't grip the autograph.
Someone?
Not you. Have a seat.
When I finished that talk, I thought now would be a good time.
Sure. Actually, Mac, there's somebody I want you to meet. Come here. Meet Jeremy. He's a good-looking kid, huh?
Faster, McLeod.
Honey, you're trying too hard. This is how to paddle. See? Slow and steady like the wings of an eagle.
Like this?
You're still too hard. Ah, now you're an eagle. Very noisy.
Where's my doll?
father would have been proud of you today, God.
McLeod, will you go away?
Why'd you ask?
Because my father did.
And you're angry with him? Connie, your father didn't choose to leave you. He was taken. I promise you, Kahani, I will never leave you.
Is this medicine?
It's great medicine.
And I'll never take it off.
McLeod taught you well today, huh?
Looks like McLeod almost went swimming.
When we saw a moose and an eagle. Tomorrow we hunt the bear, please.
Think you better just stick with the fish.
I'm not afraid of the bear. See what McLeod gave me? It's very strong medicine, only for warriors. What about the bear?
Well, first the deer, then we'll hunt the bear. Ah. Go on, go practice your bow.
You love Kahani, don't you?
As if he were my own.
But already I see him growing headstrong like his father.
Since McKenna was killed, you've been good to us. To me.
McKenna was my friend. Mm-hmm. You think his spirit minds me taking his family as my own?
It was his wish. I think his spirit would be glad you're such a good father.
And what does his wife think?
That she's still young, and that a warrior should have many children.
The three of us are enough.
But why?
Because I'm at peace for the first time since I can remember. This is my life, my home. You and Kahani are all I'll ever need.
They're so handsome. Sometimes I forget that you're really a white man.
Like the blue coats?
I watch you when you can't sleep at night. I know that you're thinking about it.
They're getting closer every day.
This is a wide land. If the soldiers come, we'll just move. How much room do they want?
As much as they can take.
I think that you are too serious.
Kahani, I thought I told you there were plenty of bow.
What do you think?
I think he's a beautiful boy. You should be proud.
I know. And he looks just like Richie. Here you go.
Bye. He's really a great kid. I'm just trying to do the right thing here.
McLeod, Richie.
Hi, Father.
Where have you been?
We were in Paris for a while.
I see. Oh, Paris. The city of my youth. I was there in 72. Oh, what a summer. All those women, all that wine. Of course, that was before I entered the priesthood.
Of course.
Showtime. I'll see you guys in church, yes?
Yes, Father.
I gotta go to Mac. I promised Jeremy I'd take him to the park.
Richie. I know this is your life, but being a father isn't a part-time job, it's a lifetime commitment.
I know, but Mac, every man's got to face that.
Yeah, but you're not every man, Richie. You're an immortal. What happens when she gets old and you don't? Or when the kid's as old as you are? What are you going to tell them?
I don't know. What I do know is they need me.
Is this about their needs or yours?
going on?
My fight.
Who is it?
Dead man.
By the power vested in me, I now pronounce you man and
woman. Do something, Father.
Get him out of here. McCloud, what is going on?
Congratulations!
McCloud, this is not a battlefield.
Right turn. Wrong foot.
This is God's house, and I think you owe these people here an explanation.
Sorry,
McCloud, stay there.
Sorry, to both. Sorry, have a nice day. I'm sorry, Father.
I don't suppose you could take five, huh? Right. Well, don't mind if I do. You know, McCloud, I think you're handling this all wrong.
What am I not handling, Charlie?
Richie being a father. You got a wrong attitude on this.
Do I?
Damn right. The kid looks up to you. He needs your support.
What kind of support should I give him?
Encourage him. Richie's doing good. I mean, he could have taken a walk, but he took on his responsibilities. Man, I wish more guys would do that.
What if it's a responsibility he shouldn't have?
I don't get it. I thought you'd be the first to be rooting for him.
Rooting for who?
The Knicks. You know, hell of a team. Ewing and Starks. Hey, look at you. Hey, how's the little guy? He keeping you up?
Yeah, I guess I'm not getting too much sleep, Charlie.
Yeah, well, you hang in there, man. It'll get easier.
Thanks, man.
And no matter what anybody says... it'll be worth it.
Didn't know if I'd find you alive. What the hell happened?
I lived.
Very funny. And the other guy?
He lived too.
So what is it between you and this biker from hell? I've never seen you like that, Mac.
His name's Kern. And I'm gonna kill him.
That's it? That's all you have to tell me?
Gee, he's my problem. That's all you need to know. You're dealing with enough right now.
Okay. Listen, I was up half the night thinking about what you said about how we're not cut out for the two kids in a garage kind of thing.
And he's still going to try and give it a shot even though he's not yours.
Mac, I can't turn Jeremy away. That's what my father did to me. This is my chance to have a normal life.
Good luck.
Connor?
Go around the fire.
Coming slowly.
Easy, mister. I ain't hunting today. Smell your coffee.
Help yourself.
Not many of our kind around these parts. Name's Kern.
Duncan McCloud.
Much obliged. Been drinking old grinds and chicory for about a week. Ugh. Any other time you need some supplies. You gonna eat all that?
You're my guest.
Damn, Army's been keeping me busier than spit. Of course, money's good.
You work for the Bluecoats.
Bluecoats? sound like a damn engine. You look like a damn engine. Yeah, I work for the Bluecoats. Best damn scout in the territory. Found the little village 10, 15 miles due west of here this morning. It was a pretty little place. At least it used to be.
You're lying.
Better watch your mouth, mister. Look at you in that Indian getup. You're a squaw man, ain't you? Yeah. You got your little woman in the village. Imagine one of us with one of them. Got a present for you, squaw man. Which one you think is her?
I'll kill you!
Come here, squaw man.
Hey, McCloud. What do you think? Is it me?
The truth?
I say it was a little out of character.
You know, I wasn't born in a museum. In fact, I'm kind of tired of hanging around old antiques like you. Look at me, I'm growing mold. Not done yet. We got the bar stocked. I'm putting a stage in over there.
Stage?
Yeah. Some blues, I thought. Buddy guy, John Lee Hooker. Can't know everything about everyone, can you?
Guess not.
Who is it?
Kern.
Never heard of him.
Now's not a good time to start lying to me, Joe. Where is he?
Forget about it.
Talk to me! Come on, Joe.
Look, last I heard he was somewhere around the East Docks.
Thanks.
McCloud. He kills for fun.
I know.
The name.
He's a big guy, drives a hog.
Hey, our clientele don't like a lot of questions.
Come on, what room is he in?
You a cop?
No, I'm his long lost aunt.
Take a hike.
I've tried to be polite so far and charming, but you don't seem to be understanding me.
You're beginning to piss me off. Now get me the key. Get it!
Top of the stairs, next to the fire escape, but I don't think he's in.
Well, let's go find out.
Maybe he cleared out.
A lot of guys skipping the rent here.
I wouldn't worry about that.
Donna, I'm telling you, this kid is gonna need a track coach.
I was thinking that it might be a good idea if we had a bigger apartment. Maybe we could rent a small house or something.
Oh, the way this kid's going, we're gonna be able to live off his Nike endorsements.
While you wait for the checks to roll in, I'm gonna try to straighten up this mess, if it's humanly possible. Ugh. Richie?
Yeah, what's up?
You tell me.
Oh, that, Donna, that's just something I have.
Richie, people don't just have swords like this. What's it for?
It's a rapier, actually. Made in Toledo, Spain about 400 years ago, and it is also very sharp.
I don't like having it around. It's not safe, Richie.
It stays.
Why?
Look, Donna, can we just forget about this?
No, no, we can't. What's it doing here?
I can't tell you.
Richie, families tell each other things. Is it stolen?
No, it's not stolen.
Then what are you hiding? If you can't trust me to tell me about some knife in your closet, how can I trust you to be his father?
How do you know I am his father?
Is that what this is about? You want me out of here?
Look, Donna, I didn't say that.
You know why it took me 2 years to tell you? Because I didn't think you could handle it. You were a kid then, and you still are. Take a look, Richie. I'm not a kid anymore.
But look, Donna, I'm sorry. I'm trying.
Try harder.
Thank you.
Richie. You think we ought to bulb light the band or use the spots?
Whatever.
Whatever. I get all these changes in my life, a new place, and does anybody care?
Sorry.
It's all right. Don't worry about it. What do you need?
Advice.
Advice. So, you come to Joe's. Everybody comes to Joe's. Talk to me.
Well, you study immortals. I figure you know more about us than anybody.
Except an immortal. I mean, you see McCloud every day. You got a question, ask him.
In some ways, it's easier to talk to you. I mean, he's been around for so long, sometimes I think he forgets what it was like the first time through.
Okay. What I know, you know.
Well, immortals aren't supposed to be able to have children, right?
That's the way it works.
But what if, you know, what if it happened before you became an immortal? You know what I mean?
It's never happened. I don't think it could.
You're absolutely sure?
Relax, Richie. We've been keeping records for centuries, and it's never happened. The kid isn't yours.
Right. Great. Thanks for your help.
Sure.
I'll see you later, Dawson.
Okay.
Richie.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. Me too.
Baptizing Jeremy will be a pleasure for me. And a blessing for you.
I'm gonna have to talk to Richie to make sure it's okay. We had a fight, so it may take a little while.
I'll be here when you're ready. Have you chosen a godfather yet?
We're thinking of asking Mr. McCloud.
McCloud. We had a little episode the other day, but all in all, an excellent choice. I'm sorry, there's someone waiting. I have to take confession. How long has it been since your last confession?
What day's today?
Tuesday.
That's a little over 500 years.
I see we have a sense of humor today. Have you sinned?
A few times.
Then open your heart and confess your sins so you may receive absolution.
You want to know all my sins?
Yes, my son.
You sure you got the time?
I have all the time you need. And don't be afraid. You're safe here.
Well, I used to like to torture a lot, but it got old after a while. So I branched out, started to rape, kill, torched a couple of villages, burned an abbey or two. Let's see, what else?
There's more?
One more thing. Where's McCloud?
McCloud?
Duncan McCloud, the guy with a sword. You know the guy you said would be a good godfather, father.
Dear God, I swear. I don't know where he lives.
Yeah. God, stealing.
She found my sword, Mac.
Really?
I don't know what to tell her.
You have two choices. Eventually, you have to tell her everything. Take her into your life completely. At least she'll have a choice about how she lives, about how Jeremy lives.
And what's behind door number two?
You let him go. You send her away, Tell her whatever you have to, but send her away and never look back.
I can't do that, Mac. I told you, I don't care if Jeremy's mine or not.
Richie, this isn't about you being a father. It's about you being an immortal. I know what this means to you. But you can't protect them. It doesn't matter what you do. It doesn't matter how much you love them or how hard you try. You just can't. Thanks, Mac. I'm sorry.
Jeremy, what do you say? You gonna give mommy a break, huh?
I'm looking for an old friend. Name's McCloud. Maybe you know him.
No.
Oh, that's too bad.
I really don't know anyone here.
Wasn't he coming to the baptism? Oh, nice kid, and a boy.
No, don't. Give me my baby.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You know he's a nice kid.
My baby.
Oh, no. I like children most of the time.
It's okay.
Why don't you run along now?
I'm sorry, Richie. I don't know why I flipped out like that.
It's okay. You were being honest. And, I think it's time we were honest about everything.
Like what?
Like, I know Jeremy's not mine.
How can you say that, Richie? The timing, the way he looks?
Donna, I can't have kids. I never could. And I never will.
I really wanted him to be yours, Richie. You weren't like the other guys we hung with. I always thought you had something special.
But listen, Donna. It doesn't matter to me, though. I love Jeremy. And I want to be there for you if you let me.
Let you? Are you kidding? What do you think I've been praying for?
Listen, Donna, there's more.
If you don't want to say it, I don't have to hear it.
Yes, you do.
Richie, what is it? Richie, what's going on?
Donna, listen. You gotta get out of here. Grab Jeremy. You gotta go to the dojo. Go out the back
Richie,
door right
what the
now.
Hell's
Donna,
happening?
Please go. Tell McCloud right now. Please.
Oh, that looks sharp. You wouldn't cut me, would you?
That's the idea.
I really wanted the squaw man, but he's not here. I expect you'll do. Well, then I'll be here waiting.
Richie's in trouble.
Come in.
There's this guy. He was breaking
Calm
the door.
Calm down. Take it easy.
There's some freak on a motorcycle breaking the door down.
Make yourself at home.
What's going on?
I think you need some oil and vinegar.
I'm lucky I didn't need a funeral.
Where's Kern?
He's back at my place and he's waiting for you.
Donna and Jeremy are upstairs.
Mac, he would have killed them and I couldn't have stopped him.
He's done it before.
Mac, what did he do to you?
Stay with Donna and Jeremy.
Over here, Squall Man. Time to die.
You're so right.
Maybe I should take the scalp for old time's sake. And your little friends.
Tito da kua kidela. Tito wa di takala. Mania!
I got great news. My cousin Ralph's got a house on 4th Street. He said if we painted and did a little work around the place, he wouldn't charge us rent.
Donna, it's not gonna work.
Sure it is. I've seen it. It's got 2 bedrooms, a big kitchen, a huge yard.
No. I mean us. We're not gonna work.
What? I don't get it, Richie. A couple days ago, we were one big happy family.
I know. I'm sorry.
You're sorry. Just like that. You say a couple words and it's over? If you didn't want us, why didn't you just tell me? Why did you have to lie to me, to him?
Donna, I didn't lie. Everything I said was true.
Then why is this happening?
I can't tell you.
Fine. We have to go.
Donna, listen. You can stay at my place until you get settled. And if you ever need anything, money, help...
We need you, Richie. Go to hell.
They won't be back.
I know.
Mac, she hates me.
You did the right thing.
Did I?
Yeah. They're alive. Come on, buy a drink.